Hello all, this is Aarti Maisekar. This presentation is all about Android platform architecture. Android provides a rich development architecture. It is always useful to know what is available in the system for apps to use. So these are the major components of the Android platform architecture. This is the topmost layer of the stack, which is called as apps. So your apps live at this level, along with the core system apps for email, SMS messaging, calendar, internet browsing, and contacts, etc. The entire feature set of the Android OS is available to you through APIs written in the Java language. You need to create Android apps by simplifying the reuse of core modular system components and services, which includes a view system, which is used to build an app's user interface, including lists, grids, text boxes, buttons, and even an embeddable web browser. Second is Resource Manager. It provides access to non-code resources, such as localized strings, graphics, and layout files. Third is Notification Manager that enables all apps to display custom alerts in the status bar. Fourth is Activity Manager that manages the lifecycle of apps and provides a common navigation backstack. And the last one is Content Providers that enable apps to access data from other applications, such as Contacts app, or to share their own data, etc. Third layer in the stack is libraries and Android runtime. So each app runs in its own process with its own instance of the Android runtime. Android includes a set of core runtime libraries that provides most of the functionality of the Java programming language. These native libraries are available to apps through the Java API framework. Many core system components and services are built from native code that require native libraries written in C and C++. Android runtime. ART is written to run multiple virtual machines on low memory devices by executing DEX, DEX files. Full form of DEX is Dalvik executables. DEX is basically a bytecode format designed specially for Android that is optimized for minimal memory footprint. For devices running Android version 5.0, that is API level 21 or higher, each app runs in its own process and with its own instance of Android runtime. In prior versions, Dalvik Virtual Machine was used as runtime. This change allows apps to start faster and consume less disk space and RAM. Some major features of ART includes ahead of time compilation, AOT that we used to call it as, then optimized garbage collection. On Android 9, that is API level 28 and higher, conversion of an app packages Dalvik executable format files to more compact machine code that makes the app to process fast, better debugging support. So what is the difference in between the Dalvik and AOT? So Dalvik Virtual Machine, it uses a Dalvik compiler, which was a just-in-time compiler. And AOT, that is Android Runtime, uses ahead-of-time compiler. So what basically Dalvik is, or just-in-time compiler, means whenever app runs in a mobile device, then the part of the code that is needed for execution of app will only be compiled at that particular moment, and the rest of the code will be compiled in the future if needed. In AOT, ahead of time compiler, it compiles the whole code at the time of installation of the app and not dynamically as the application runs. In Dalvik, it has a smaller memory footprint, and due to this, it uses very less physical space on your device but needs more execution time. So Dalvik will do the compilation part only when it is needed. in AOT by compiling the whole code during the installation results in no lag. So in AOT, the whole code will get compiled while installing the app itself. It is not a need-based compilation. Apps will get executed fast, but the problem with this is they may occupy more memory space. The next layer in the stack is hardware abstraction layer. This layer provides standard interfaces that exposes the devices hardware capabilities to the higher level Java API framework. So the Android application uses HAL API, that is hardware abstraction layer APIs, to get service from hardware devices. The HAL consists of multiple library modules, each of which implements an interface for a specific type of a hardware component, such as a camera or Bluetooth model. When an API framework makes a call to access device hardware, and the Android system loads the library module for the particular hardware component, and it will be available for the rest of the layers to access it. And the last layer in this is a Linux kernel. This is the foundation of the Android platform. The Android runtime relies on the Linux kernel for functionalities like threading, a low-level memory management, etc. Using Linux kernel allows Android to take advantage of its key security features and allows device manufacturers to develop hardware drivers for a well-known kernel. So this is total in-depth view of Android platform architecture, starting from the system apps, Java API framework, then libraries and Android runtime, hardware abstraction layer, and Linux kernel. So this is what about this presentation. Thank you for watching. Bye.